Are you building a client portal and you want to do it with data living inside of Google Sheets? Well, if so, you are going to love this video because I'm going to be showing you how you can get set up very quickly with a template inside of Softr that uses data all stored inside of Google Sheets. So if understanding how to put this together for your organization is of interest, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth. I'm the owner here at Gap Consulting, and it's our mission to help you get organized and automated with no code. Softr is one of our favorite no code tools. It allows people to interact with the user interface that you build for any web application, and it can use data that's living in Airtable, in Google Sheets. They even have their own internal storage option as well that's currently in beta. As I mentioned at the beginning of this video, I'm going to be showing you how to do this in Google Sheets, and I want to invite you to follow along with me. So please go ahead and download the template. I'll include a link below wherever you found this video so that you can get started in your own Softr account and get sent right to this template that I'm going to be sharing. If you already have Softr, go ahead and open it up. Let's hop on into my screen and we'll go step by step. First thing is I want to be in my Softr account, and also I want to have logged into my Google Sheets. Now I'm going to blur out all of my other Google Sheet information for privacy issues, but we're going to be creating a new Google Sheet here inside of our Google Sheets account. So back here inside of Softr, if I'm starting from scratch, I can go to New Application, and you'll see that I have a bunch of different templates to choose from. Now, Softr is going to show us which of these templates are available inside of Google Sheets. This little icon right here shows us that we can build this very template with Google Sheets on the back end. So I can just click right here, get access to the client portal. It's going to build all the components inside of Softr and create that backend that we need in Google Sheets. So I'm going to go ahead and click on the client portal here, and I will use this template. Now I need to select my data source, and this is where I need to sync up and integrate with my Google Sheets. I've already built that integration here. If you haven't, you need to add that data source first. Since I already have the connection, I'll just select my Google Sheets account right here. And the very next part will be to continue, and we're going to load up that Google Sheet background, that template inside of our Google Sheets. It's copying all of the data, and we're just like that, ready to go. So let's go ahead and first flip into Google Sheets, and where it did not exist before, now I have a copy of a client portal by Softr. So I can go into this, and this particular sheet that was just created for me is the back end. This is the data that's going to drive that web application inside of Softr. So at first glance, I see that I have four different sheets here. I have users. These are the people who are going to be able to log into my application. I have clients. That's a different organization entirely. I have projects here. And then lastly, I have invoices. So presumably those invoices are invoiced against a project. And so all of this information, at least I have some sample information already built for me inside of Google Sheets. Now let's flip back to Softr Studio and we can say, let's go to that application. So this is actually going to load up the application that is being created or has been created from that very template. Now here at the top, we see we have a bunch of different headers. Don't let this confuse you. These headers are going to be different based on the permissions of whoever is logged in to the application. So based on your permission level and what you have access to inside of the application, you will see a different variation of this, but only ever see one of them. You can always go in and see who has what visibility by clicking on a particular element, in this case, the fourth header, and go over to visibility. Here inside of the application, we see that there is a very specific user group called admins. I'll show you in a moment where we can dictate all of these different user groups and even make some changes to them if we want. Similarly, though, we can click on the third header here, go to visibility on the block, and we see that this particular header is available to non-logged in users, which makes sense because that header has a login option. This second header on visibility, this is being made available to our consultants. And then lastly, the first header is available to our clients. So we now have our client portal that's giving our clients access to our information, but also making that portal available to our consultants on our team as well. Everybody has their own different experience inside of this application, and that's all dictated by the user groups. So let's dive into user groups and take a quick look at this. In order to access the user groups, find the users on the left-hand side. And inside of this, we can hit the user groups tab. Now we're going to see that we have three different types of groups created, and this aligns with the four different headers. Remember, the fourth group is people who are not logged in, and then everybody else who is logged in is going to fit into one of these three groups. And we have different rules that are set up for these different groups. We can click on edit here to see what exactly those conditions are. So there is a role field somewhere that I'll show you in just a moment that is associated with the type of user that we have. If we go back into our data, again, that lives in Google Sheets, and we flip onto our users sheet, we see that we have this role field here, and there are different roles available. We see that we have admin, consultant, and client. And so this is where we are getting the information back in Softr to decide which role every user is going to have inside of the application. All of that is driven by this simple field back inside of Google Sheets, where we're saying what role somebody has inside of the application. Not only can we decide what blocks and pieces of information different people see, but we can also dictate what they can do inside of the application. We can set up different rules and different actions for the different user types. So for example, if we were to look at projects here, we might set up a rule inside of projects that says, hey, you can only see certain projects based on your type of user. So here, for example, in projects, we must be logged in order to see this block, and only the clients and consultants can see the My Project section. The admin doesn't actually see this. So over here, we see there's a different block. This particular block, if we go to visibility, is only available to admins. So in this way, we're able to cultivate a very unique experience in the application based on the user roles. We can change what header they see, we can change what block they see, we can give them buttons to push or take certain permissions away, all of that based on user role. Now that we have an understanding of how users are getting different levels of permissions inside of the application, let's take a look at what the application does. In order to flip through the different pages on the left-hand side here, we'll simply go to pages again, and these are all the different pieces or components of our application. So at a quick glance, we see that we have the home page, projects. We can then drill into the projects and see granular detail on the projects. We have clients. We can drill into clients. We have consultants, details on consultants, invoices, and then of course your standard login and forgot password and reset password. But in order to understand what the application actually looks like from a user perspective, let's publish this application. Click on publish in the upper right corner and confirm that we're publishing it. And now we have already just launched our application that simply. Now, in order to access the application, we can go back to users and we can access the magic link for some of the users inside of our application. Now, in order to understand what user experience we're going to get, let's flip back into our portal and take a look. Charles Lynn here is our admin. So let's access this portal through the admin perspective. We'll go back to Softr here and we will find Charles at the bottom. Here's Charles. I can copy his magic link and in a new tab, open it up. And now I will be impersonating Charles inside of this application once it loads. Now immediately we see that we're logged in because up here we have an avatar picture. And if I were to sign out, I can do that right here. But I can drill in and see all of the information about the different projects, clients, consultants, and invoices that we have. I can drill into this particular project, the Google Ads campaigns. I can then see what's going on with that project, take a look at the team that's been assigned to it, drill into that team component. All of this, of course, is completely customizable. I can go in and change the colors, the fonts, the very navigation of this entire template. But it's amazing that I can, with just the push of a few buttons, create this entire template that's driven from data that lives back in Google Sheets, and now launch this application out to both my clients and my team as well, so that everybody has all this information at their fingertips. Now, I know we went pretty fast in this video and really only scratched the surface. So if you have any questions, please be sure to drop them below. And in the meantime, keep on building.